Hello, my dear student. Today, I would like to talk on high anion gap metabolic acidosis. Causes of this topic with short discussion on every point. And the lecture will be ended with lactic acidosis. At first, what are the causes of high anion gap metabolic acidosis? High anion gap metabolic acidosis may be caused by exogenous acid load or endogenous acid load. At first, on the right, exogenous acid load, that means acid load in the body from outside. It may be poisoning of any content with acidic criteria, acidic nature, like aspirin poisoning, methanol poisoning, and ethylene glycol poisoning. In your MCQ exam, this option may be may come in different variety, like aspirin poisoning or salicylate poisoning. Methanol poisoning actually leads to formation of formate, and ethylene glycol poisoning leads to formation of glycolate or oxalate. All these oxalate, glycolate, formate or salicylate, these elements are active metabolite of this poisonous substance, and they leads to acidic condition with high anion gap. Now, the endogenous acid load that may cause high anion gap metabolic acidosis. What are they? They are diabetic ketoacidosis, starvation ketosis or ketoacidosis, alcoholic ketoacidosis, lactic acidosis, and kidney disease. At first, diabetic ketoacidosis. The question is, why does the diabetic patient develop diabetic ketoacidosis, that is ketoacidosis? The explanation is, for the synthesis of ketoacidosis, some hormonal influence is needed, like deficiency of insulin. Write down here, deficiency of insulin, excess of catecholamine, and excess of steroid hormone, sorry, stress hormone like glucocorticoid. I repeat again, for the synthesis of keto acid, hormonal influence are deficiency of insulin, excess of catecholamine, and excess of glucocorticoid or a stress hormone like glucagon, growth hormone. These combination, these hormonal imbalance actually leads to formation of ketone body in excess amount. You know, ketone body normally produced in our body in a very small amount, and the ketone body are actually highly energy yielding substrate. But when the ketone body is produced in high volume, high amount, more than the capacity of the liver, then the ketone body will be accumulated, and as the ketone body are acidic in nature, so they produce metabolic acidosis. You have to know that there are three main type of ketone body. They are known as acetic acid, beta hydroxybutyrate, and acetone. All these three are weak acid. Actually, normally they are produced, but when they produce in high amount, then the condition is called ketosis and ketoacidosis. And the acetone, it exhale through the patient's lung, and the breath may take a sweety odor due to presence of acetone in breath, exhale air. So insulin deficiency, catecholamine excess, glucocorticoid excess, all these factors leads to high amount of ketone body formation with diabetic ketoacidosis. In starvation ketosis, again question is, why does some people develop or prone to develop starvation ketosis? Actually, starvation ketosis develop when food intake is decreased in situation of high glucose demand. I repeat again, why does starvation ketosis develop? The answer is, starvation ketosis develop when food intake is decreased in presence of high glucose demand. Now the question is again, what are the situation where high glucose demand are? Number one, neonate. Number two, pregnancy. Number three, lactation. Number four, any stressful condition like surgery. These are the stressful condition or special situation where glucose demand is high. And if in this condition the patient go through any degree of starvation, even just 2 to 3 hours, then the patient can develop a starvation ketosis, and from that point high anion gap metabolic acidosis. Okay, now alcoholic ketoacidosis. Actually, alcoholic ketoacidosis patient are chronically alcoholic, and chronically alcoholic patient are chronically malnourished. And alcoholic ketoacidosis actually develop when these chronically alcoholic, chronically malnourished patient have an event of binge drinking. That means a heavy drinking of alcohol. And these heavy drinking of alcohol on the background of chronic alcoholism predispose the patient for the development of alcoholic ketoacidosis. I will discuss the lactic acidosis last. Before that, kidney disease. We know through the kidney, the oxidative metabolites are excreted like urea, creatinine. In kidney disease, the oxidative metabolite cannot pass through the urine. That means this organic substance, most importantly urea, accumulated in the body, that means plasma, that leads to high anion gap metabolic acidosis. Now the lactic acidosis. Lactic acidosis, definition of lactic acidosis is very simple. Acidosis due to excess accumulation of lactic acid in the body. Now the question is, why does lactic acid in high amount produced? To give the answer this question, you need to know the type of lactic acidosis. Type 1, there are two types. Type 1 lactic acidosis, when there is excess production of lactic acid in tissue. Of course, lactic acid is produced in the tissue by anaerobic glycolysis pathway. If there is any degree of hypoxia, if any degree of tissue hypoxia, that tissue hypoxia leads to anaerobic glycolysis, and from that anaerobic glycolysis, lactic acid is produced. Now question is, why there is hypoxia? Hypoxia that produce lactic acidosis is usually profound circulatory failure, and this profound circulatory failure is called shock. Virtually any degree of shock any type of shock can lead to circulatory failure with hypoxia and subsequent lactic acidosis. For example purpose, you can give heart failure. This heart failure may be acute left ventricular failure, may be from myocardial infarction. The shock may be hypovolemic shock. The hypovolemic shock may be from diarrhea, vomiting, burn, bleeding, or sweating, excessive sweating of course. So any type of shock in any degree can lead to hypoxia with subsequent lactic acidosis. So number one, or type 2 lactic acidosis. Number two, the type 1 lactic acidosis, already I said. Now type 2. In type 2 lactic acidosis, the problem is decreased metabolism of lactic acid. The problem is in type 2, decreased metabolism of lactic acid. We know the lactic acid is produced in hypoxic tissue, but it is metabolized in the liver. Repeat again, lactic acid is produced in the hypoxic tissue, but actually it is metabolized in liver. So if the patient have underlying chronic liver disease or liver disease, maybe acute liver disease or chronic liver disease, does not matter. Okay, acute liver disease, acute liver hepatic failure. Acute or chronic liver disease may cause metabolic acidosis due to lactic acidosis type 2, and there are some drug or toxin. The important one I would like to talk, that is metformin. Metformin is important oral hypoglycemic agent used in the treatment of type 2 diabetes patient. These metformin can reduce hepatic metabolism of lactic acid with subsequent accumulation of increased lactic acid with acidosis, that is lactic acidosis with high anion gap. Actually, all the patients taking metformin don't develop lactic acidosis. Some group of people, mostly diabetic patient taking metformin, when they go through a special situation, a stressful condition like surgery, intercurrent infection, or starvation. Patient taking metformin, if go through this type of stressful condition, then the patient are prone to develop metformin induced lactic acidosis. They have other multiple cofactor. So this is the ending of this short lecture on high anion gap metabolic acidosis and lactic acidosis. So thank you very much.